solve a homogeneous differential equation y double prime plus x square y prime plus x y is equal to 0. So first of all, let's take a look at p of x and q of x. So p of x is equal to x squared and q of x is equal to x. So x equals 0 is an ordinary point. Alright, so our solution is given in this form, y is equal to power series from 0 to infinity c in x to the n. So I'm gonna take the first derivative gives me power series from 1 to infinity c in n times x to the n minus 1. Bring down the exponent, subtract the exponent by 1. Second derivative is equal to power series from 2 to infinity c in n times n minus 1 times x to the n minus 2. Again, bring down the exponent, subtract the exponent by 1. Okay. So y doesn't n start at 0 for y prime and y double prime. So for y prime, it n doesn't start at 0. It's because when you plug in 0 into this one, it will make this become 0, okay? Same for this one, if you plug in 0, either 0 or 1, it will make this become 0. So that's why n has to start at 2 for this one, right? Now I'm going to plug this into the differential equation. So we have y double prime, which is power series from 2 to infinity c n n times n minus 1 x to the n minus 2 plus x squared y prime, and which is power series from 1 to infinity c n times x to the n plus 1. So you have x squared times x to the n minus 1, same base, which is x, so add the exponent together, so 2 plus n minus 1, which is n plus 1, okay? Plus x times y, which is power series from 0 to infinity c n x to the n plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, now let's move this over here. Right, now let's take a look at the exponent. So n equal 2, so x to the 0. When n equal 1, we have x to the 2nd, and when n equals 0, we have x to the 1st. So x to the 2nd is the highest exponent. So we are going to run out term for the first and the last power series. So the first one run out two terms. So when n equal 2, plug in 2. So c2, 2 times 2 minus 1, which is 1. So in x to the 0, which is 1. So I have 2c2 plus when n equal 3. So plug in 3, 3 minus 1 is 2. 3 times 2 is 6. 6c3x plus power series from 4, so n equal 2, n equal 3, n equal 4, 4 to infinity, c n n times n minus 1, x to the n minus 2, okay? Now for this one, just rewrite it, plus series from 1 to infinity, c n n times x to the n plus 1, okay? For this one, We have to run out one term for that one. So plugging 0 into this one, so we have c naught x plus 3 from 1 to infinity c n x to the n plus 1 is equal to 0, okay? Alright, so now let's take a look at the index. So we have n equal 4, n equal 1, and n equal 1. So n equal 1, n equal 1, so n equal 4, so I'm going to reindex this, okay? All right, so watch carefully what I'm doing here, okay? Do not skip the video because you will not understand what I'm doing here, all right? So I'm gonna put this down here. So reindex this to 1, so lower 3, that means I'm gonna increase 3 for every single n inside here. So I have cn plus 3, n plus 3, n plus 2 x to the n plus 1, cross this out, right? Now we are going to combine like terms. So constant, well, actually it's not constant, so just write out non-series terms first, which is 2c2 plus, okay? Now for the x terms, so I have 6c3x plus c naught x, so I'm going to factor out x. So I have 6c3 plus c naught, multiplied by x. Now for the power series, Okay, I'm gonna write it down here because I think I'm gonna need a lot of space for this power series. So power series from n equal 1 to infinity of, so they do have x to the n plus 1 in common, so I'm gonna factor out x to the n plus 1 and put it at the end, okay? Now what I have left in parentheses is cn plus 3, n plus 3, n plus 2, which is this one. And the second one is, oops, plus, so look at this, cn times n, and this is cn. So I'm going to factor out cn, and have that in parentheses is n plus 1. Okay, I'll multiply by x to the n plus 1, this equals 0. Okay, now let me move this over here. Alright, now let the coefficient, now we are going to replace coefficient, so for x to the 0, we have only 2 c2, it's equal to 0, that means that c2 is 0, okay, 6c3 plus c0 equals 0, so for the biggest c, so c3 is equal to negative c0 over 6, okay, now, for this one, all everything inside the bracket is your constant, okay? So cn plus 3, n plus 3, n plus 2, plus cn times n plus 1 is equal to 0. So for cn, oh, first, remember, solve for the biggest cn, okay? So cn, I have cn plus 3 and cn, so cn plus 3 is the biggest cn, so cn plus 3 is equal to negative cn times n plus 1 divided by n plus 3 times n plus 2, okay, and starting from 1, 2, 3 all the way to infinity, okay, right, now when n equals 1, I have c4 equals, so 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, so negative 2c1, okay, over 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 times 3, and equal 2, have c5, is equal to negative, so plug in 2, so 2 plus 1 is 3, 3c2 over 5 times 4, so 2 plus 3 is 5, 2 plus 2 is 4. Now c2, remember back to this one, c2 is 0, so this becomes 0, now n equal 3, with c6 is equal to, plug in 3, so 3 plus 1 is 4, negative 4 c3, over 3 plus 3 is 6 times 5, and what is c3? So c3 is negative c0 over 6. Right here, so negative c0 over 6. Negative c0 over 6, right? So, simplify this a little bit. You have 4 c0 over 6 times 5 times 6. Okay, just leave it like this. Okay. Alright, I think that's enough. Now, I'm going to write our solution. So y equals c0 plus c1x plus c2x squared plus dot dot dot. And c1 is c0. It's c0 plus c1. We don't know. Just rewrite it. C1. Yes. C2. So c2 is 0. C3. C3 is negative c0 over 6. So c0, c1, c2, c3, c4. C4 is negative c1 over 4 times 3. That's to the 4th. C5, 0. C6 is 4 c0 over 6 times 5 times 6. X to the 6 plus dot dot dot. Okay, can you guys see these dots? Right? Okay, I'm trying to squeeze my solution into this page. Right? Now, see, this is my c0, c0, and c0, okay, so factor out c0, have 1 minus 1 over 6 x cubed plus 4 over 6 times 5 times 6 x to the 6th plus dot 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 plus c1. So c1, I have x minus 2 over 4 times 3. Can you guys see it? Yep. X to the 4th. Oh, okay, I need one more term. I can put it out here. Okay, try to squeeze everything into one page. So n equals 4. I need to generate one more. It's okay to stop right here, but as always, I want to have three terms for each. So, have c6, now c7. Back to this one. c7 is equal to negative c. So n equals 4, 4 plus 1 is 5, negative 5c4 over 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 times 6, okay. Alright, now what is c4? c4 is negative c1 over 4 times 3. So plug them in. Negative 5 or 7 times 6 times negative 2 c1 over 4 times 3. Simplify this. So let's simplify this. So I have 5 times 2 is 10 c1 over 7 times 6 times 4 times 3. Okay, that is my c7. Right? So just c1. So plus 10 over 7 times 6 times 4 times 3 x to the 7. Plus dot dot dot. Alright. Alright. Sorry for the mess, but that's how it was. Alright. Alright, this is your answer. I'll see you next time.